Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Foreign Correspondents Club of Japan. My name is Khaldun Azari. I'm president, and I'll be honored to moderate this event today. Our guest today will talk about a very important issue that has been in the news recently. And let me introduce them first. To my very right is Mr. Mitsuru Miyasako. He is the Director, Provisional Release Association in Japan, PRAJ. And to his right is Mr. Soichi Ibusuki, and he's a lawyer and legal advisor for this organization, Provisional Release Association of Japan. The talk, of course, today is about the foreign detainees on hunger strike. There are some reports that some of them are still on hunger strike in some detention houses in Tokyo or other parts of Japan. And this issue has been lingering for the last few years without much media attention. So we hope today that we will disclose some information about that issue. The event today will be about for about 20 minutes. Their speech and presentations, including translations from Japanese to English, and that will be followed by questions and answers. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our guest today. Thank you.
Thank you
very much for inviting me today.
東京入管で行われた大規模な搬送について報告させていただきます。
I would like to give you a report on the large-scale hunger strike that is underway in the Tokyo Immigration Bureau Detention Center.
まず、搬送の概況についてです。
First of all, I'd like to give you an overview of the hunger strike itself.
5月9日火曜日の夕食時から東京入管 A ブロックの非収容者22名によって開始されました。
From around dinner time on the evening of Tuesday, the 9th of May, around 22 detainees in A block began a hunger strike.
その後、H ブロック、G ブロックなどでも呼応して、最大時70名規模のハンガーストライキになりました。
After that, there was communication with the detainees in H block and G block, resulting in more and more people joining the hunger strike, which at its peak was involving around 70 people.
さらに、名古屋入管でも15日、16日の2日間、30名が東京入管のハンストに共感してハンストを行いました。
Subsequently, over the 2 days of May the 15th and 16th, a further 30 people who were detained at the Nagoya Detention Facility also went on hunger strike in support of the detainees in Tokyo.
この時、全国で約100名がハンストをしていたことになります。
This means that at one point there were around 100 people across the country engaged in a hunger strike.
東京入管でのハンガーストライキは心身の衰弱また病状の悪化から徐々に参加人数が減り22日段階今週月曜日の段階で5名ほどが続けていましたが23日火曜日には全員が食事を取るようになっています。
Due to a decline in their physical and psychological condition of these participants in the hunger strike in Tokyo, and also a worsening of their health conditions, the number of people participating gradually decreased. And as of the 22nd, which was Monday this week, there were only 5 people still refusing food. But as of Tuesday the 23rd, they're all eating again.
最後までハンガーストライキを続けていたメンバーに私昨日面会して気持ちを聞いたんですけども、彼らが言うにはもう自分たち の体力は限界だと、一方で自分たちの戦いが広く社会的に報道されたことから入管が変化するかどうか様子を見てみたいということでした。
I recently met with the people who committed to the hunger strike right until the end, and they reported to me that they were physically at their limit. But they reported to me that they felt that their concerns had been reported widely in general society, and they plan to now wait and see what the response of the Immigration Bureau will be.
A ブロックでは当初、10名近くが水も飲まないと確保しました。 まあ、そのため12日から14日にかけて中国人、ナイジェリア人、バングラデシュ人の3名が意識を失って救急搬送されました。3名とも回復し東京入管に戻っています。3名が倒れた段階で全員水は飲むようになりました。
At the beginning of this hunger strike in Block A, nearly 10 people undertook to not even drink water. And for this reason, in the three days between May 12th and May 14th, three people, one each from China, Nigeria and Bangladesh, lost consciousness and were taken away in an ambulance. All these three people have recovered since and are now back at the Tokyo Immigration Bureau Detention Facility. At the point that they collapsed, they began drinking water again.
次にこのハンストの目的や特徴についてお伝えします。
Next, I'd like to talk to you about the goals and the characteristics of this hunger strike.
一番強い要求は再収容をやめることです。
The number one goal of this hunger strike is to end the practice of repeated detainment.
退去命令が出されても帰国できない難民、移民は過酷な長期収容に耐えて仮放免となります。しかし仮放免後もなかなか難民認定や在留特別許可が下りず、仮放免期間は長期化しています。仮放免者数が過去最大となる中、入管はこれを問題視し、2016年1月から仮放免者の再収容を始めました。今回の東京入管でのハンスト参加者の半分以上はこうした再収容された人たちであり、3回目の収容をされている人もいます。 A ブロックの22人で見るとうち15人が2回目の収容中です。初めて収容される人たちも、身近に2回目3回目の収容されている人たちがいる中、自分の未来に不安を感じ、また入管のやり方に憤りを感じて最終反対の戦いに共感してハンストに参加しました。
These refugees and immigrants who have been issued with an extradition order must endure long and grueling periods of detention before they are given a provisional release. And even after they have received such permission to be released provisionally, their application for asylum or special permission to stay in the country is often not approved for long periods of time, leading to people being in limbo on this status. So this has led to a situation where the numbers on provisional release have reached a historic high. The Immigration Department has seen this as a problem and so began a crackdown that began in January 2016. So more than half of the detainees who were involved in this hunger strike fall into this category of those who have been re-detained. And some of those who were there for the first time, of course, they see their fellow inmates, detainees being detained, released and detained two or three times, leading to feeling some uncertainty about their own future. So these people have feel very angry about the methods of the Bureau of Immigration and are participating in the hunger strike to fight against this system of repeated cycles of detainment, release and re-detainment.
次に今回のハンガーストライキでの東京入管の対応の問題点について報告します。
Next, I'd like to talk to you about some of the issues with the way that the Immigration Bureau is operating.
一つに各ブロックの要求書を受け取らないという問題があります。
One issue is that the petition from the people on the hunger strike has not been accepted by the Immigration Bureau.
5月9日、A ブロックのハンガーストライカーたちが要求書を渡そうとしたんですが、それを入管は拒み、それどころか暴力的に制圧をして、3名が負傷しました。
The participants in the hunger strike attempted to hand over a petition to the workers at the detention center, but that was refused, and actually they were violently suppressed.
5月19日になって、支援者、これ私ですけど、私に対してその要求書の提出方法はあるということで伝えてきましたが、そのハンストをしている当事者には入管は直接は伝えていません。
On May the 19th, I, as one of the supporters of these people on the hunger strike, was informed by the Bureau of Immigration about the methods by which this petition could be handed in, but this information was not conveyed directly to the people participating in the hunger strike.
次にハンガーストライカーの体重を測らないという問題です。
The next issue is that the body weight was not measured. The body weight of the hunger strikers was not measured.
通常入管の収容施設でハンストが発生した場合、非収容者の健康管理に責任を負うため、毎日入管はハンスト者の体重を測ります。
Normally, you would expect that the Bureau of Immigration would fulfill their obligations to protect the health of detainees in the case that a hunger strike began by measuring the body weight of those individuals on a daily basis.
しかし今回、A ブロックのハンスト参加者については、5月12日金曜日になってやっと初めて体重を測りました。
But in the case of the participants in the hunger strike in Block A, the first time that their body weight was measured was on Friday the 12th of May.
その後も間が空いて、18日以降はほぼ毎日体重を測るようになっています。
Then there was a gap, and then the next time that their weight was measured was the 18th, and then subsequently daily.
で、東京入管はメディアに対して、給食を食べなくてもカップラーメンを食べているとか、あたかもハンストが偽装されているような主張をしています。
The Tokyo Bureau of Immigration has reported to media that even though they may not be eating the meals provided to them, that they are eating cup noodles in an attempt to portray this hunger strike as a fake.
ならば、体重測定をすればはっきりとする問題です。それをしないでいて、偽装だというふうに主張するのは情報操作でしかありません。
If this were the case, then measuring the detainee's body weight would be clear proof of this fake. But by not doing so and continuing to claim that it was a fake is nothing less than an attempt to manipulate the truth.
じゃあ次にハンストのこの背景について報告します。
I'd like to now move on to the background of this hunger strike. Go ahead.
日本では難民も移民も入管法のもとに一元的に置かれています。
In Japan, currently both refugees and immigrants come under the same law, the Immigration Control and Refugee Recognition Act.
難民申請をして審査中である者が、もう一方では不法入国者、不法残留者として退去命令を出されているという、法律的にちぐはぐな状態に置かれています。
For this reason, individuals can simultaneously be applying for asylum and also be subject to an extradition order for having entered or resided in the country illegally. This places them in a very messy legal predicament.
日本で非正規滞在者問題が出てきたのは、1980年代後半のバブル景気の時からです。それから30年以上を経て、いまだに非正規の状態に置かれていることが問題を深刻化させています。
This issue of irregular residency or illegal overstay is one that began in at the end of the 1980s during the bubble economy, and over the subsequent 30 years, these people have been still in this murky status of irregular residency. This has made the situation even worse.
今回のハンスト参加者には1985年11月に来日し、オーバーステイのまま働いてきたパキスタン人もいます。ちなみに彼は2回目の収容です。
For example, one of the participants in the hunger strike is a Pakistani who entered Japan in November of 1985 and continued to work after overstaying his or her visa. He has or she has now been detained twice.
日本政府は2004年から非正規滞在外国人の摘発を強化しました。そのため非正規滞在外国人は激減しましたが、摘発された中には本国に帰国すると迫害の危険性があるもの、日本人や永住者と結婚しているもの、あるいは長期にわたって日本で暮らし生活基盤を日本に移したものが含まれています。
The Japanese government began cracking down on these illegal residents from 2004, leading to a dramatic reduction in their numbers. But even having these come to the attention of the authorities, these people often face the fear of persecution if they return home. They're often people who are married to Japanese nationals or foreign nationals with permanent residence in Japan. So they, in effect, have moved their foundation of life, of living here to Japan.
その方たちは長期収容に耐え、例えば以前だと2年から3年の長期収容が普通でした。そして病気になって仮放免されました。
These people often endure long periods in detention. It's not unusual for them to be in detention for 2 to 3 years. And then once they become ill, they're released on provisional release.
大量に摘発すればするほど一定の割合で仮放免者が増えるという結果になっています。
The mass prosecution of overstayers has led to a certain increase in the rate of numbers of people on provisional release.
仮放免者は以前は500名もいませんでしたが、2015年末で3606人にまで増大しました。
In the past, there were times when only around 500 people had the status of provisional release, but by the end of 2015, there were 3,606 people with this status.
入管から仮放免許可を受けて生活する仮放免者ですけれども、在留資格がないため就労できず、社会保障制度からも排除されています。こうしたグレーゾーンの存在が増大し、かつ仮放免期間が長期化することは、本人にとって人道的問題であるとともに、社会的にも問題です。
People in this situation have no official status of residence and for this reason are unable to work, and they also fall outside of the welfare system umbrella. This gray zone has increased, and the length that people must live, length of time that people must live in this gray zone is getting longer and longer, which is not only a humanitarian concern for the individual in question, but is an issue for the whole of society.
これに対して入管は再収容などによる強硬的な仮放免者数削減策を採用しました。
In the face of this situation, the Bureau of Immigration has decided to take a very heavy-handed approach to reducing the number of people on provisional release by engaging this practice of re-detainment.
今日配布した読売新聞のコピーですね。これその辺の事情について書かれています。
One of the handouts that you have in front of you is an article from the Yomiuri Shimbun newspaper, and that will give you some more background on this very issue.
帰国できない事情があるため、長期収容にも耐え、仮放免生活にも耐えている人たちを再収容しても、新たな苦痛を与えるだけであり、大きな人権侵害です。
These people are often not in a position to go back to the country of their origin and so must endure long periods in detention. And after struggling to live with the status of provisional release after they leave detention, they are often re-detained, leading to nothing more than renewed pain. So this is a gross violation of human rights.
私たち仮放免者の会は入管による再収容についてはですね、入管による収容権の乱用だと批判しています。また仮放免者への在得基準の緩和をもって仮放免者数を減らすことを入管に要求しています。
We at the Provisional Release Association in Japan condemn the Bureau of Immigration's abuse of power of the right to detain individuals over and over again. We call for a relaxation of the criteria for special permission to stay in Japan and for the Bureau of Immigration to work to reduce the number of people who are in limbo under this status of provisionally released.
ありがとうございました。
では私指宿から、少しだけお話しさせてください。
My name is Ibusuki and I would like to add a few words, please.
まず一つは、入国管理局が、長期収容、再収容の問題についてです。
First of all, I'd like to focus upon the issue of long-term detention and also repeated detention practiced by the Bureau of Immigration.
入管が外国人に対して退去強制令書という書類を発行したときに、 無期限に収容することができます。
The Bureau of Immigration, when it issues an extradition order, has the right to detain a person indefinitely.
つまり10年でも20年でも理屈の上では100年でも収容ができるわけです。
And so it's within their right to detain someone for 10 years, 20 years, theoretically even 100 years.
そして入管はこの収容権を長期の収容権を外国人を自費で帰国させるための圧力をかけるために使っています。
I believe that the Bureau of Immigration is using this right to detain people indefinitely as a way to put pressure on these people to self-deport, that is, pay for their own way back to their country of origin.
本来、外国人も含めて全ての人間に人権が保障されているはずですが、日本の法律制度の中では在留資格のない外国人には人権が保障されていないような状態があるのです。
Of course, all human beings should have their human rights protected, but currently under Japanese law, individuals, human beings who do not have a residence status, in effect, do not have the rights of their human rights protected.
あるハンスト参加者は私に今回のハンストに参加する理由を次のように述べました。いいですか。入管は私たちのことを人間として扱っていない、これに抗議するためにハンストをするのだというふうに言いました。
I recently spoke with one of the participants in the hunger strike who said to me the reason that he is participating is because he feels that the Immigration Bureau is not treating him as a human being and he would like to protest this situation.
ぜひこの入管の問題を多くの方に知っていただくために皆さんに報道をお願いしたいと思います。
I would like as many people as possible to hear about this situation, so I ask for your cooperation in spreading the word in the media.
以上です。
That's everything from me.
Thank you very much. We open the floor. If you have any question, please raise your hand and come to the front. And we will start with the working press, our journalists. First question, please.
マイクが
ございます。Roger, good to see you.
一人ずつ出るかと思います。
Régis Arnaud, Le Figaro, you passed an article of the Yomiuri Shimbun, and so far Yomiuri Shimbun was not very active on this topic. But recently I noticed an article about a refugee trying to reach his daughter in his home country. Do you feel that Yomiuri Shimbun or the mainstream press is getting more sympathetic to the issue, to the cause of immigrants? Thank you.
Sorry, can I have your name again?
My name is Régis Arnaud, Figaro.
From Figaro, Régis Arnaud.
はい、フィガロ氏の、アルノさんですけれども、読売新聞の、記事を配布していただきまして誠にありがとうございます。読売新聞は、こういった問題を取り上げることはあんまりないんですけれども、読売新聞のような、主要メディアは、この問題、まあ、難民問題、移民問題を、最近より、好意的に取り上げている傾向にあると思いますか？
そうは思いません。読売新聞は確かに、まあ、以前は難民や移民の問題をあまり取り上げ、記事としてあまり取り上げていませんでしたが、すみません、まあ、近年は記事を掲載することが増えました。しかしその記事の中身は、例えば入管側の意向に沿ったものだというふうに私は評価しています。
I wouldn't say that the mainstream media is becoming more sympathetic to issues of immigrants and refugees, and it's true that they may not have dealt with this so much in the past. I do think that there has been an increase in the number of articles relating to these issues, but if you look at the content of these articles, they tend to be on the side of the Immigration Bureau.
います。まあ、その意味で入管側が何を考えているのか、次にどういうキャンペーンを張りたいのか、まあ、それを知る上では読売新聞は最も研究材料として私は重視しているところです。
However, by reading these articles, I believe that you can get a good feel for what the Bureau of Immigration is feeling and also what their upcoming campaigns may be. And so for that reason, I think it's important to read articles in the Yomiuri newspaper to get a grasp upon the internal thinking of the Bureau of Immigration.
Yuri Kageyama with Associated Press. I understand that not all the people who are being detained are trying to get refugee status, but they have not been charged with any crime. That's correct, right? So could you give us more of an example of how they ended up there? It says most of them are Filipino. And then when we talk to the immigration, they tell us, well, we just invite them to go back. Why don't they go back? That's what they keep saying. So can you please answer the question so that we understand better as reporters why they can't return and why they deserve to be in Japan?
Sorry, can I have your name one more time? Excuse me, is it Akagawa?
What is it?
Your name, I'm sorry, can I just have your name one more time?
Kageyama.
Kageyama.
AP の Kageyama です。はい、収容されているすべての人は、難民申請をしているわけではないと思うんですけど、もちろんその中に何人か、いると思うんですけれども、その内訳についてちょっと話していただきたいのと、そして犯罪を犯して収容されていないという理解でよろしいでしょうか。そしてもう一つなんですけれども、収容されている人の、なんというか、実例を挙げていただきたいと思います。フィリピン人は一番多いというふうに聞いているんですけれども、どうやってどのような過程で収容されているのか、ちょっと具体例を挙げて話していただけたらと思います。直接入管に聞いてるんですけれども、入管いわく、出国して帰国してくれればそれはそれでいいと思いますけれど、なかなか、帰らないのは何ででしょうかというような、質問、答えが戻ってくるんですけれども、一般的な収容者、非所有収容者の、様態というか、どのような方なのか、描いていただけたら助かります。
はい、まず、難民申請者の割合についてですが、収容されても、まず収容されると、摘発され収容されると、大半の方は帰国します。で、しかし、帰れない事情の方々が長期収容になり、そして仮放免者になります。でこの長期収容者および仮放免者の中で言えば、半分強が難民申請者だというふうに、私はそういうふうに実感しています。
People who are detained for whatever reason, around half of these people would decide to go home of their own accord. But for those who are left behind, around a little bit more than 50% of those would then go on to apply for asylum.
難民申請者以外の方々について言えば、例えば日本人と結婚した、あるいは、永住者の方と結婚した、あとは、もうオーバーステイがになって長い中で、オーバーステイ同士日本で知り合い子供ができ、もうその子が、中学生になっている、まあ、この場合ファミリー全体がオーバーステイですけれども、もう子供が日本で生まれ学校に通い一定の学年に達していると、まあ、そういう方々もいらっしゃいます。
As for the other people who are not applying for refugee status, to give you an idea of what sort of people they are, they're often people who have married a Japanese citizen or a person who has permanent residence in Japan. And these people have overstayed their visa but have continued on for whatever reason, having a long-term life here, having children. Sometimes people who are both overstaying their visas meet and marry, have children, and then stay here illegally and have children who are in junior high school, for example. And in this case, the whole family is technically an overstayer, has the status of overstayers, even if the children have been there all their lives.
具体例。
はい、具体例お願いします。
例えば、フィリピンの方の具体例について言えば、バブル景気の頃から、 遅ければ2003年ぐらいまでの間に入国されている方が圧倒的に多いです。で、この2003年までは日本ではオーバーステイの方が働くことについてほとんど問題になりませんでした。例えば彼らが交番に行って、おまわりさん、私オーバーステイですけど、このまま日本に行っていいんですかって聞いても、いや、聞くとですね、仕事何してるのと聞かれて、あ、建築業ですとか工場ですと言えば、あ、頑張れよと言われて終わりです。
I'd like to give you some concrete examples now. For example, one Filipino person I knew came in as part of the bubble economy. People who came up in the bubble economy, for example, as late as 2003, the people who came here before 2003 would fall into this category. These people, until that point, really didn't have a problem living inside Japan. They could even go to one of the local police boxes to ask a question. And even if they had said directly to a police officer, I'm an overstayer, the police officer probably would have at that point just said to them, oh, really? What's your job? And if they responded, oh, I work in the construction industry, the policeman would say, oh, great, try really hard, do a good job.
つまり当時の日本はそのオーバーステイの方々を労働力として積極的に活用していた。でもっと言うならば、バブル景気の頃は求人のためにフィリピンとかアジア諸国にリクルーターが行って募集をかけたわけですね。まあ、そうやって、まあ、ある意味当たり前のようにオーバーステイになって働いていた。そして、
At that time, it was not unusual for people to overstay their visa and work on. This was something that was necessary to support the bubble economy. So these workers were very accepted. And even there were recruiters who went mainly into Southeast Asian nations to recruit people to come and work inside Japan. And even if their visas expired, it was understood that it was okay for them to continue working here.
それがまあ2004年から急に不法滞在者を取り締まるということで警察が動いて逮捕が始まって、まあ、帰国するように迫られました。
However, the situation changed dramatically. Suddenly in 2004, the police started cracking down upon overstayers and sending them home.
まあ、しかしすでにその頃には日本での生活が長くなっていて、まあ、帰国できない、まあ、もう日本での生活の方にもう慣れているとか、あるいはもう結婚して子供が学校に行っているとか、そういうフィリピンの方々がたくさん生み出されました。
However, at this point, many of these people had been in the country long term and found it really difficult to go home. They got used to living here in Japan. They got married, they had children, and so it was very difficult for them to go back to their country of origin. Many Filipinos fall into this category.
よろしいでしょうか?
Does that answer your question?
Yes.Next question. Yes, please.
Daniel Hurst, a freelance journalist. You've spoken about the cruelty of the system, re-detention and so on, keeping them in detention for a long time. But what are the conditions like inside these detention centres? How well are they treated or otherwise by the staff? How safe is it in those centres? Thank you.
はい、フリーランスのダニエル・ハーストと申します。システムの残酷さについて話していただいたんですけれども、私が聞きたいのは、それではなくて収容所の中の、状態はどうなっているのか、待遇はどうなっているか知りたいと思っております。職員 による待遇はどうなのか、そして安全に生活しているのかについて話していただきたいと思います。
はい、まず収容生活については雑居房、雑居生活が基本です。雑居
As for their living standards inside the detention center, they're living in a communal environment.
4人部屋から11人部屋ぐらいの部屋がありまして、そこに国籍をミックスして入れられます。
They live in rooms of up 4 to 11 people in each bedroom, and all of their nationalities are mixed up.
部屋の広さはだいたい定員数プラス1畳で ですから、5人部屋であれば6畳、7人部屋であれば8畳というのが大体の法則です。
8畳という畳の
8畳ですね。畳ですね。はい。
Normally, the size of the room would be relating to how many people are inside it, and it's measured by the jō counter, which is the number of tatami mats. So if there is four people, they would have a five tatami mat room. If there were six people, they'd have a seven tatami mat room.
そこにおける、まあ、職員の対応につきましては、まあ、以前は暴行事件など多発していましたが、裁判が起きたり、あるいはメディアが取り上げる中で、まあ、随分と暴行事件は減りました。
Regarding the treatment by the staff inside these detention facilities, in the past there were many incidences of violence against the detainees, but court cases and also the reporting of this in the media has led to a decrease in violence inside detention centers.
職員たちの被収容者への接し方もだんだんフレンドリーになってきました。
I also feel that little by little the officials are becoming more friendly towards the detainees.
しかし2013年から入管はまたその非正規滞在者への攻撃を強めてきたので、現場の職員たちの対応もまただんだんと厳しく悪いものになってきています。
However, I think the situation, there was a turning point in 2016 when there was, 2013, when there was a decision to crack down more upon illegal overstayers. And little by little, the attitude of the officials inside the detention centers has got worse.
あと、医療問題は極めて深刻な問題です。
I think the situation with medical care is very serious.
2013年以降、東京入管で2人の被収容者が死亡しました。
Since 2013, two detainees have died inside the Tokyo Immigration Bureau's detention center.
茨城県にある東日本入国管理センターでは3人が死亡しました。
And three people have died at the East Japan Immigration Detention Center in 茨城 Prefecture.
一番新しい今年3月25日に東日本入国管理センターでベトナム人が亡くなったんですが、まあ、この方はくも膜下出血です。
今年の3月15日ですね、
はい、3月25日
ですね、はい、今年ですね、
はい、
This year on the 25th of March and a Vietnamese detainee at the East Japan Immigration Detention Center died from a subarachnoid hemorrhage.
彼は亡くなる1週間ほど前から頭が痛い、頭の後ろ、首、肩が痛いと必死に訴えました。
This individual, from a week before he passed away, complained of a severe headache in the back of his head and that he had a sore neck and shoulders.
しかし入管職員ですね。職員は、まあ、彼が大きい声を出すし、立ち上がることができるから仮病だと考えて医者に見せませんでした。
However, the officials at the detention center, not medical officials, the regular officials at the detention center, made a decision, a judgment that because he could cry out in a large voice and he was able to stand up on his own, that it was obviously him faking this illness.
彼は亡くなった後、警察によって司法解剖されました。
After he passed away, the police conducted an autopsy on the body.
そして死因がくも膜下出血であるということが明らかになりました。
And that was how the cause of death was determined, and that was a subarachnoid hemorrhage.
つまり彼は1週間前から血管が破れて脳内に出血し、本当に痛くてしょうがない。しかも1日1日その痛みは増していったはずです。
Which means for 1 week prior to his death, there were veins in his brain that had broken, and so his brain was basically bleeding. And apparently the pain would have got worse and worse each and every day that it went on.
本当にこうやって繰り返される死亡事件、まあ、本当に許しがたいことで、なんとか変えたいと私たちも、また被収容者も考えているんですが、残念ながら今に至るも 解決はしていません。
These repeated incidents of death in detention centers, inside detention centers, are unacceptable. And I myself, and also the detainees, are calling for an improvement in the situation. But sadly, they are continuing.
Thank you.
少し補足をします。他の非収容者も、その対何か体におかしいところがあって医師の診察を求めてもなかなか診てもらえないということはとてもよくあります。
I would like to add a few words if I may. When detainees complain of a medical condition, it's often the case that they are not allowed in a timely manner to see a medical professional.
あと緊急にひどいその痛みが生じたり発作を起こしたりしても土曜日日曜日それから平日の夜間は入管に医者がいないので、医者に診てもらえないし、また外の外部のその医者に連れていくこともほとんどしません。
If there is a sudden medical emergency or they display some sort of a turn or some medical complaint, if it happens to be in the evening of a weekday or on a Saturday and Sunday, there are no doctors on duty in the detention facilities and so they cannot be looked at by a medical professional. And it's very rare that people in detention centres would be taken out of the centre to be seen by a medical professional at a regular hospital.
一度私の依頼者が東日本入国管理センターに収容されている私の依頼者が土曜日に、ひどい痛みを訴えて、私に電話をしてきたことがあります。で、入管が医者を呼ばないので私は救急車に電話をし消防署に電話をして救急車を呼びました。しかしその救急車は入管の入り口で追い返されてしまいました。で、彼は結局月曜日まで医者に診てもらうことができませんでした。こういうことが日常茶飯事に行われています。
For example, I'd like to give you my experience at the East Japan Immigration Detention Center. One of my clients there rang me on a Saturday complaining that of extreme pain and complaining also that the immigration bureau was not allowing him or her to see a doctor. And so on this person's behalf, I rang an ambulance to send it to the detention center, but it was not allowed in the entrance, through the entrance of the facility. And this individual had to wait until Monday morning before they could see a medical professional. This is something that happens on a daily basis.
Thank you. Just to follow up on that, detainee that died, was there any accountability by the detention or by the authorities? Did the government try to investigate and punish the responsible people? Or it just said, sorry, that's it?
No, the police have not investigated the Bureau of Immigration.
また、この今年3月のベトナム人の死亡事件の時に、東日本入国管理センターの所長の北村さんのコメントは、自分たちの仕事は適切にやっているというコメントでした。
With regards to the incident, the fatal incident, the death in March this year, the head of the East Japan Immigration Detention Center, Mr. Kitamura, said that we did an appropriate job.
この繰り返される死亡事件、5人の方が亡くなりましたけど、誰かが処分を受けたと、入管の組織の中でですね、誰かが処分を受けたという話は全く聞きません。
Even though there have been repeated incidents of deaths in detention centers, five in recent years, I have never heard of anyone inside the Immigration Bureau being investigated or prosecuted.
というよりも、外国人が死んでも誰も処分を受けない という今の日本政府の体制があるからこそ、入管は力ずくで非正規滞在の人たちを長期収容したり、無理やり飛行機に乗せたりということを平然とやっているんだと思います。
The very fact that the Japanese government does not prosecute anybody for the death of a foreign national means that the immigration bureau is emboldened to engage in these practices of long-term detention, repeated internment, detainment, and also forcefully putting people on planes to extradite them to their home country.
Thank you. Next question. Okay. Let me. Any question? Roger, please.
I have a couple more questions. First, regarding the Vietnamese guy, if I'm correct, the inside of the jail is filmed and maybe also recorded. If it's the case, there are some records of what actually happened the night he died. Is it correct? And is it possible to access to this record? And second, I think Japan has to host a criminal UN convention in 2020, if I'm correct, which would maybe force the government to look more seriously into this issue. Do you have hope on this matter? Thank you.
はい、さらに2つの質問を付け加えさせていただきたいんですけれども、1つ目に、ベトナムの死亡者についてなんですけれども、刑務所というか、収容所の中に、カメラがついているのではないかと思いますので、記録があるのか映像が残っているのか知りたいと思います。そして、あったとしたらそれを、公開していただく可能性はありますか。そして2つ目の質問なんですが、日本は、おそらく2020年かと思うんですけれども、ある刑事の会合、何らか国際コンベンションを、実施するというふうに聞いているんですけれども、それを、受け、日本政府がこのような問題を、直視するのではないかと思うんですけれども、それに対して何か希望を持たれていますか。
はい、まず、1点目についてですが、その亡くなったベトナム人は、1人部屋にいました。まあ、では原則は複数の人たちのを共同生活させますが、まあ、彼については1人部屋に入れていました。しかしその部屋は本当に重病の方が入る部屋ではなかったので、カメラはついていません。なので彼が亡くなっていく状その過程を撮影はされていません。
With regards to your first question about the death of the Vietnamese person in detention, at the time of his passing away, he or she
男性ですか。
あ、男性です。
He was living in a room by himself. Normally, people would live together in a communal bedroom, but in this case, he was living alone.And so it was not also, actually also this room was not one that was used, would be used for a person who was in a severe medical condition. So there was no recording of what happened inside that room. And so there's no way to look at a recording or any evidence of how he passed away.
2点目の質問に対する答えですが、その2020年の国際コンベンションについては私は知りませんが、日本政府が自らこの入管収容の問題を改革するというつもりは全くないと思います。
I'm not certain about what convention you're referring to in 2020, but what I can say is that the Bureau of Immigration has shown nointention of reforming their systems by themselves.
例えば先ほどの入管の医療の問題については、日本弁護士連合会が、日本政府に対して改善をするように勧告を出したことがあります。しかし、その後もこのような死亡事故が起きていますし、また改善されたと改善の方向性は全く示されていません。
For example, with regarding to the medical the problems with medical treatment inside the detention centers, the Japanese Federation of Bar Associations made a recommendation to the government about improving this situation. But even after this recommendation was handed to the government, there were more incidents of deaths in custody, and so there's really no hope, I think, for them to be making any improvements on their own volition.
これは日本の政府、つまり行政だけ、失礼、ちょっと言い直します。日本の、行政のみの問題ではなくて、入管のやっていることが裁判になっても、それをチェックする機能が裁判所がこれをチェックをして違法であるという判断をすることがほとんどないということがもう一つの背景としてあります。
Another issue is to do with the Japanese administrative procedures in these matters. Even if there is a prosecution, actually there's not actually been any prosecutions of the Bureau of Immigration in these matters.
日本の最高裁はかつて、次のような判決を出しました。外国人の人権は在留資格の枠内で保護されるに過ぎないという、まあ、有名なマクリーン事件判決という判決が確か1973年だったと思いますが、に出しています。この判決に基づいて日本の裁判所は在留資格のない外国人の人権に関しては非常に消極的な態度を取っています。このことも入管が変わらない一つの大きな要因になっていると思います。
This relates very much, I think, to a judgment of the Japanese High Court made in 1973, the famous McLean judgment, in which the High Court said that the human rights of foreign residents in Japan are protected to the extent possible under their residence status, which means that for people, for the Japanese government, they're not very active in promoting the human rights of foreign residents, and this is something that has led to the situation where the Bureau of Immigration feels emboldened to be able to infringe upon human rights based upon the judgments of the High Court in 1973.
Thank you. Yes, please.
ロイターの宮崎と申します。ちょっと確認なんですけれども、先ほどの話の中で23日から全員が食事をとっているということなので、ハンストは9日に始まって23日に終わったという理解でよろしいんでしょうか。それとあと要求書は結局最後まで入管は受け取っていないのでしょうか。先ほど宮迫さんの方に渡す方法あるということが伝達されたという、それはどういう方法なのか、それを通じて要求書は渡っているのか、いまだに渡っていないのか、その点確認お願いします。
Hello, my name is Miyazaki from Reuters, and I would like to clarify some points that you have made. Can I just double check that the hunger strike began on the 9th of May and finished on the 23rd? Is that correct? Also, with regards to the petition, you said that the Immigration Bureau had not accepted it. I'd just like to clarify that, because you also said that they told you how to submit such a petition. So have they been able to take advantage of this method and hand in the petition? Or have they still not handed in the petition?
まず1点目 のハンガーストライキの期間ですけれども、5月9日の夕食から5月22日月曜日の夕食までハンガーストライキが行われたということだと思います。
Yes, as for your first question, that's correct. The hunger strike began at dinner on the 9th of May and finished at dinner on the 23rd of May.
次に要求書ですけれども、いまだに渡ってはいません。
As for your second point, the petition has still not been accepted by the Bureau of Immigration.
で、まあ、5月19日金曜日に総務課の職員が私に要求書を提出、局長宛ての要求書を提出する方法がありますということを言ってきたんですが、それは具体的には東日本入国管理センターと、まあ、同じですということでした。
On Friday the 19th, I had a discussion with the administrative department at the Tokyo Immigration Detention Facility, and they informed me of the method that I could submit this petition to the head of the immigration, Bureau of Immigration in Tokyo. And that route, the method was exactly the same as the route that is used at the East Japan Immigration Detention Center in Ibaraki.
過去東京入管よりも東日本入国管理センターの非収容者の方が大規模な激しい戦いを繰り返してきました。
すみません、最後は
大規模な激しい戦いを繰り返してきました。
The East Japan Immigration Detention Facility is a larger facility than the one in Tokyo.
それはその中で東日本センターで確立されたルールがあります。
There are rules that have been set in place in the East Japan Immigration Detention Center. They were set up there.
それはその各ブロックの要求書、またそのブロックの その賛同人の連名のサイン、これに、アプリケーション、申し出書というものを入管からもらって、この申し出書に代表が何らか記載して、申し出書、要求書、サイン、この3点セットで、まあ、東日本センターの場合、所長宛てですけど、まあ、所長宛てに出せば、必ず回答するというのがルールになっています。
At the East Japan Immigration Detention Center, there is a set method by which detainees can petition or send their ideas to.The head of that detention center. There's a form that they can fill out. There's a place for them to fill in their names and to write down what it is that they are concerned about. And there is a rule that the head of the East Japan Immigration Detention Center would always respond to those concerns.
で、まあ、私から東京入管の総務課の職員に東日本センターではこういうやり方があるが、どうして東京入管ではそういうやり方を取らないのかと、まあ、東京入管はともかく、まあ、意見箱に入れろと、意見があるなら意見箱に入れろとしか非収容者に対して言わないので、まあ、そういうことを私から、まあ、問いかけていました。それに対する答えとして、まあ、調べてみたところ、東京入管でもそういうやり方はありますと、東日本センターと同じようにしてくれれば必ず局長からの答えを出しますということでした。
In comparison to this formal system, in the East Japan Immigration Detention Center, when I spoke to the officials in the Tokyo Immigration Center, all they would say to us is that they could put their comments in the comment box.That is located inside the center. But I told them that there was this formal method for receiving comments from detainees at the East Japan Immigration Center. And then sometime after that, they came back to me with a response saying that, yes, we can also follow the same procedures that are undertaken in the East Japan Immigration Center.
で、実はこのことは今回のハンガーストライキが生み出した今のところ唯一の成果だと思います。今まで東京入管はそのようなやり方は実際認めていませんでした。
I think this acceptance of this, the formal method of taking in submissions of comments from detainees is the only concrete outcome of this current hunger strike. It's the one thing that we have definitely achieved out of the hunger strike.
Thanks. Sienna?
にちは、CNN の若月と申します。この難民、日本の厳しい難民政策、それから移民政策というのは非常に昔からの話で、先ほど2013年からその不法滞在者のクラックダウン、取り締まりがかなり厳しくなったというふうにおっしゃってたんですけれども、それには何か特別な理由があるというふうにお考えでしょうか。それでしたらばどういったことがその変化の背景にあるのかというのを教えていただきたいと思います。それから、ちょっと厳しい意見になるかもしれないんですけれども、一国にはやはりその国の移民政策を取る権利というのがあって、日本は非常に厳しいことを取っているんですけれども、制度的におかしい、例えば難民申請が何度でもできるとか、そういったことがあるというふうに思うんですけれども、どのように、こういった難民政策、あるいはその移民受け入れの体制というのが変わるべきだ、法滞在者の取り扱いが変わるべきだというふうにお考えなんでしょうか。お願いします。
My name is Wakatsuki from CNN, and I have two questions, one of which relates to the harsh policies regarding refugees and immigrants in Japan. And you said that from the year 2013, there was a crackdown upon illegal residents. Can you explain to me why this is the case? What is the background for this change? The second question, it might be a kind of a harsh judgment, but do you not think that it is the right of any country to set out their own immigration system? There are some problems, but how would you like to see the immigration and refugee system improved into the future?
まず、1点目の、2013年から厳しくなったということにつきましては、これは、はっきりしていると思うんですが、2012年の12月に安倍自民党政権が復活しました。復活といいますか、安倍自民党政権になりました。もうこの時から入管はどんどん強硬策を打ち出してきました。
As for why there was a crackdown in 2013, I think it's very clear to say that the reason is that the Abe government, the LDP government led by Mr. Abe, was re-elected in December of the year previous to that, in 2012. That's the main reason for a crackdown. And that has led to the heavy-handedness of the Immigration Bureau.
次に制度や政策の問題ですが、2つのことをお話ししたいんですが、1つはオーバーステイにといえども、もう日本での生活が例えば10年15年長くなっている方については、在留特別許可を与えてもらいたいと、これは本当人道的配慮としてお願いするしかないですけれども、そういうふうにすべきじゃないかというふうに思っています。でもう一つ、難民認定制度のことが出ました。で確かに日本は何度でも難民申請ができます。しかし、じゃあその中で2回目の難民申請、あるいは3回目の難民申請によってやっと難民として認められるというケースがあります。なぜこのようなことが起きるのかといえば、日本の難民認定制度の特に一番の問題は、裁判をやれば勝てるぐらいの、その膨大な証拠を求めます。だから入管が難民として認めない、それに対してそれは不服だということで本人が裁判を起こす、そしたら裁判で本人が勝つ、それぐらいの証拠があるんだったら難民として認めますよということです。しかし、そのような膨大な証拠を最初から日本に持ってこれる難民は極めて少ないです。どうしても2回目の難民、3回目の難民申請、その状況の中で徐々に証拠が集まっていって、2回目、3回目でやっと認められるということがあります。
すみません、一
つ。OK。
追加します。いいですか。
はい。Yeah. OK。Yes. The system, regarding the system and policies and what I think, how I think those two things should change. First of all, with regards to the overstayers, sometimes these overstayers have been in Japan and lived here for 10, 15 or more years. And so from a humanitarian perspective, I think it should be the case that the system approves their staying in Japan under the special permission to stay in Japan provisions. The second thing about the refugee recognition system, it's true that people can apply
apply over and over again to apply for asylum here in Japan. And some of these people, it takes two or three times before their applications are accepted. But I think the main problem is that the huge amount of evidence that the Japanese government requires asylum seekers to provide in support of their application, so much so that in some cases the refugees, the asylum seekers must go to court and prove to a judge that they are in fact genuine refugees. And it's only these people who have a large amount of evidence to support their case that are successful, that are usually these are the only ones who are successful in getting their approval, their asylum application approved. But if you think about it, what percentage of refugees have the ability to collect all of this evidence and then bring it with them as they flee from their country? This is a very unlikely scenario, and so only a minority of people are able to prove incontrovertibly that they are genuine refugees. And so for the majority of people, they must apply over and over again, gathering evidence little by little to the point that they eventually are able to convince the Bureau of Immigration of the genuineness of their claim.
Yeah. 日本にも非正規滞在外国人を救済する制度はあります。それは在留特別許可という制度です。これが正しく運用されていないことが大きな問題だと思います。
There actually is a system to support, to give support to illegal people who are here illegally, and that is called the Special Permission to Stay in Japan application. This system is not operating properly.
入国管理局自身がこの在留特別許可についてのガイドラインを出しています。そしてこのガイドラインの中で、日本人や永住者と結婚している外国人やそれから長期に日本で滞在している外国人に対して在留特別許可を与えることができるという基準が書いてあります。これをきちんと適用していけば、多くの仮放免者が在留特別許可を得て日本に合法的に滞在できるようになると思います。これを速やかにやっていくことが重要なことだと思います。
The Immigration Bureau themselves has put out a list of guidelines for this special permission to stay in Japan system. For example, there are clear rules that say that if a person, an illegal resident, is married to a Japanese citizen or a person who has permanent residence inside Japan, then they are eligible to be given this special permission to stay inside Japan. The problem is that these guidelines are not being properly applied, and so if these guidelines were to be implemented, very many of the people we are talking about today, those on provisional release, would be able to get this special permission to stay in Japan status, thereby receiving a legal status of residence and be able to continue living in the country.
Just quickly follow up, what are the role of the embassies of these detainees? Did you notice that their embassies try to do something or raise the issues with the Japanese government? Very briefly, thank you.
そうですね、大使館から例えばその死亡事件とか収容問題とかについて どこかの国の大使館が日本政府に抗議したという話は私は全く聞いてないです。
I've never heard of any embassy protesting to the Japanese government with regards to the, for example, the death of a national in detention or the long-term detention of their nationals.
Thank you.That's very encouraging. Thank you very much. All right, that's, this wraps up our event today. Thank you for coming and have a nice evening. Thank you very much. I have special thanks for Matt Douglas who did the great interpretation today. Thanks.
ありがとうございます。